Hello everyone, I'm Norman Wildberger. As you probably know, I have an interest in ancient mathematics in the old Babylonian direction. I would like to expand that and initiate a new series of videos on ancient mathematics more generally. So I want to broaden our view to try to get at an overall picture of what mathematics in ancient times, very broadly across the entire world, might have looked like. So ancient times, the Mesolithic period from around 10,000 BC, Neolithic period around 7,000 to 3,000 BC, we have a Copper Age around 2500 BC, Bronze Age around 2000 BC, and an Iron Age following that. We have ancient civilizations, which are sort of starting around the Copper Age, a little bit before perhaps, Sumerians, Egyptians, Chinese, Indian, and perhaps others as well. So we know quite a lot about these ancient civilizations, but I'm interested in actually going back beyond them, further in time back, to situations where we don't know a lot in terms of written records, where the archaeological evidence is more sporadic, where maybe there's vast cultures that are even yet undiscovered, maybe underwater. But we do have lots of sites. In fact, a wide variety of really interesting sites from ancient times, including Göbekli Tepe in Turkey, Stonehenge, lots of interesting places in England, Karnak in France, Newgrange in Ireland, and many others, including many other countries across the world. Turkey, Peru, Bolivia, France, Great Britain, India, Malta, Egypt, Middle East, Portugal, Ethiopia. There's a long list of fabulous, interesting sort of megalithic sites where there's something going on. And we're particularly interested in the mathematical aspect of what might have been going on in these very ancient times. So the question that we're mostly interested in is, what can we learn about mathematics and astronomy in ancient times? And notice that I'm including mathematics and astronomy almost together here, and that will be sort of typical for a lot of our investigations. We'll see that it's really hard to separate early mathematics from early astronomy. They are very closely linked. So modern writing begins perhaps around 3000 BC, perhaps a little bit earlier, in Egypt and Sumeria, roughly around the same time. So before that, we do not have written records, but we have a lot of other kinds of evidence. For example, we have a lot of megaliths, stone objects which have been erected or created in patterns. We have dolmens, some kind of stone graves. We have lots of tombs more generally. And sometimes there's a strong mathematical suggestion there. There's some kind of patterns inherent there that we can study and say, well, these people knew something or were interested in something astronomical or mathematical. Of course, we also have lots of archaeological sites with pottery and necklaces and bones and other remnants, but perhaps a lot of that is not so directly applicable to the mathematical side of things. So there's a vast field, and we're kind of focusing on the mathematical side of things. Otherwise, it's just too vast, and there's no way we can deal with it. So mathematically, objects or topics of interest would probably certainly have included astronomy, studying the heavens and what's going on up there. There would have been an interest in calendars and timekeeping, in geography, in understanding the structure of the world in the nearby region, and maybe even a little bit broader. Funerary objects, ancestor worship, these are things that perhaps have a mathematical manifestation, at least suggested by some of the megaliths that we have around. Of course, there would have been trade even from early times, so they would have had some kind of bartering or some kind of appreciation for quantity. Measurement and weights and surveying would have also been important once people became agrarian and started cultivating fields. So these are some of the aspects that sort of have a mathematical aspect that we can sort of look for in ancient civilizations, the remnants of. Now, some natural questions that I think will arise in this situation are, what are the common features or distinctions between mathematical or astronomical activities across various regions? Do we have separate developments that are more or less unrelated, or do we see some broader trends that are throughout an entire region, or maybe even quite globally. And can we create the best theories to explain current mysteries? So I don't want us to just say, well, they did these incredible things and we have no idea how they did them or why they did them. So I feel as if we should have some theories. These theories may not be the final word, but at least we should be able to put out some explanations that at least possibly cover the evidence that we have in front of us. And let's try to steer clear of aliens. Okay, so I think we don't need to introduce aliens. Our aim is to try to explain what these ancient peoples were doing in the context of them being human beings, not so much different from you and I. And to try to understand them from this human point of view and try to put ourselves back in that framework that they may have had and try to see things from vantage point of 10,000 years ago. It's interesting, but I don't think it's impossible. And by best theory, well, it explains the most as efficiently as possible. Okay, we want theories that are reasonably powerful, they explain stuff, but they don't do so in an elaborate, meandering, you know, artificial kind of way. So how might we start such a project? Well, I think some good places are to, first of all, get an overview of Mesolithic and Neolithic cultures and sites that have a mathematical aspect. We need to understand the major sites and what they have to offer in terms of painting a picture of the megalithic world. Then we have to understand Earth-centered astronomy. We have to think about the way the heavens look like to ancient peoples. Yes, I know we have this solar system view now that's been, you know, the result of thousands of years of development and so on. But we have to, without abandoning that knowledge, we have to let go a little bit of that point of view and try to see things from a primitive person's point of view who's still looking at the night sky and trying to figure out what's going on. That would have been a very important preoccupation for ancient peoples. Perhaps the original, the inspiring motivation, the start of mathematics, very likely is somehow associated with understanding the patterns and the mysteries of what's happening in the night sky. So we want to look at that story, but from an ancient kind of point of view. Closely connected with that is, we want to understand early calendars and timekeeping. The discreteness of a day is a fundamental unit. It's perhaps one of the fundamental units of something that's recurring that we can count and that we have some interest in, you know, when it comes back to the same period in the next year. So this is an important kind of thing. So it probably connects with religious aspects too, and certainly has a mathematical aspect. And another place that we can try to make some progress is to go back to the ancient cultures that we do know quite a lot about, the Egyptian, the Sumerian, the Chinese, Indian cultures, and which is a roughly period 3000 to 1000 BC, and sort of look at roughly what they were doing and sort of project backwards. So if we can see some development that's going on here in these cultures, then we can look and say, well, if we extrapolate backwards roughly, you know, what possibly could people have been doing a few thousand years before that? I think that helps us. It sort of positions us. It gives us some kind of anchor because we actually know quite a lot about these civilizations. So I think we need to look at them with some care. Okay, so this is a very broad outline. This is a project that I'm hoping to do rather in a leisurely way over the years to come, so it's nothing that's going to happen very quickly. Every so often I will add a video or so on this topic, and I'll just want to move towards painting a broader and better picture of what mathematics was like in the ancient world, what we might be able to say about this fascinating topic. So I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.